The United States gives out longer sentences than any other place on the face of the earth. Europe looks at us like we don't know what we're doing. It looks like we're crazy.
Most of the people on this list are from America. Life sentences in Western Europe is around 12 to 25 years, while in the States, we have seen people serve out like half a century behind bars. Is this too cruel and unusual? Well, I'll let you guys be the judge of that. Is there a point in time where people have reformed and no longer become a threat to society? I'm not sure.
Many have serious mental illness. All of them are old. And a few will never get out alive.
Well, people on our list are the few people that were able to outlive their prison sentence. They were pretty old when they left prison, but at least they got a chance at freedom. Well, how's it going, all you most amazing people? I'm your host for this one, Landon Dalitzing, and welcome back to another most amazing top 10 video. Thank you guys so much for always coming back. We're almost at 6 million subscribers. Make sure you become a part of the most amazing family here on YouTube by hitting the subscribe button. And just letting you guys know that this video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. It's a brand new free-to-play collections RPG game that is taking the mobile gaming landscape by storm. If you guys want to play, make sure you guys click the special link in the description below. It is a highly addicting game and I really enjoy playing it, especially when you can unlock new champions. There are over 400 champions to collect. I just unlocked the Death Hound and it looks absolutely sick. I added him to my main team. He's really weak and he dies a lot, but I'm trying to power him up so he can hold his own weight in battle. I'm currently playing the campaign mode and I just unlocked the Catacombs of Narbuk and also the Durham Forest. Right now, almost 10 million people worldwide have already downloaded the game in just 3 months. Is this real life right now? The game is growing super quick, so make sure you guys check out what the hype is all about by clicking the link down below, and you'll instantly get 50,000 silver and a free epic champion as a part of your new player program to start your journey. I think the game is amazing, but you know what? Don't just take my word for it. There's already been over 200,000 reviews on this game. Raid has almost a perfect score on the Play Store. So let me know if you guys have downloaded it, and what do you guys think of the game? Let me know in the comment section below. There is a new awesome rewards program for new players. Get a new daily login reward for the first 90 days in the game. And you guys can even play against me. Make sure you guys come find me at Landon YouTube. So far, I have 7 champions with almost 7,000 champion power. So thanks so much for Raids for sponsoring this video and making this video possible. Alright, let's jump right into this one. This is the top 10 convicts who outlived their life sentence part 2. If you guys need to get caught up with part 1, make sure you guys click right over here. The first part of this video almost has a million views on it, which is absolutely insane. Alright, number 10, we have Eddie Collins, who spent 43 years in prison after the Justice Project became involved, and after 12 years, they were able to prove that Eddie Collins was actually innocent. Is this real life right now? Oh, and side note for you guys, is this real life right now? Shirts is coming very, very soon, and I'm gonna be giving out free ones to you guys. All right, getting back into this, I got totally excited there. Well, going back to this, it took 43 years to prove that the justice system locked up the wrong person. Collins was convicted of first degree murder, but it was actually his brother that committed the murder. But in 1973, his brother took a plea deal that only landed himself 10 years in prison, and he confessed that he didn't do it, Eddie did it, it was his brother, he was the shooter. Eddie was just 21 years old, and his younger brother, Johnny, was just 17 years old at the time. It was a drug deal that went wrong. I guess with Johnny being a minor, the justice system allowed him to take a plea deal in exchange for him to say it was his brother. So his brother was convicted for the next 43 years. The longest serving prisoner in the United Kingdom at the time, well, he was just released last year. He's up next at number 9. We're talking about John Massey, who spent 43 years behind bars and was finally released at the age of 69 years old. He was handed a mandatory 20-year life sentence, but he spent more than double that time. During his time in prison, his mother was dying and he asked if he can go see her on her deathbed, but he was denied compassionate leave. Well, after 43 years, he was released from prison as an innocent person. I hate that this is a very common trend. It's just so heartbreaking hearing how much time these convicts spend behind bars for crimes they did not commit. I really don't feel bad for people who are behind bars for a very, very long time. You know, the ones that actually commit horrible crimes. Number 8, we have Richard Phillips, who spent 45 years in prison, and again, going with the trend on this one, he was innocent.
There is no price to put on freedom. That's yours. That's something that you were born with. And you should be able to continue to be free until the day you die without anybody or any entity or any state coming in there taking your life away from you. They don't have the right to do that.
Well, Phillip's rights were taken away from him when he was convicted back in 1972 for a murder he didn't commit. When he was released from prison at the time, he was the longest serving wrongfully convicted prisoner in US history. Phillips was paid $1.5 million from the Michigan Wrongful Imprisonment Compensation Act funds. There was a law that passed that dictates that exonerated ex-inmates be paid $50,000 for each year spent in prison who were innocent. I think that is total BS. I would fight for $1 million for every single year that I had to spend behind bars as an innocent person. Because you know what? At the end of the day, you can't even pay me $1 million to go to prison fearing for my life every single day for a year. $1 million just ain't worth it for me. This man would have received $45 million. I've seen people win millions of dollars for way dumber lawsuits. Moving into number 7, we have Sheldry Top, who served 57 years in prison. It's so crazy to think that we have someone who have served 57 years in prison, and we're only at number 7. As we go on this list, the prison time gets longer and longer. Sheldry Top was finally released from prison when he was 74 years old. I'm a brown guy, I did the math. It means he was in prison when he was 17 years old, and he was convicted for murder. Do you guys think it's fair for a 17-year-old to be sentenced to 57 years behind bars? In this case, we do believe the justice system did get it right. This was the right person who committed the crime, and on his way out of prison, he addressed the murder. I mean, he wasn't denying it.
Out of respect for the Davis family, I have no comment this time.
So Sheldry walked into prison as a young teen with a whole future ahead of him, and now he slowly walks out with a walker with not much ahead of him. Must be hard for the family seeing this man walk free, and the person he killed will never have the same opportunity. Up next, we have Harvey Stewart, who served 60 years in prison. He comes in on our list at number 6. Stewart served 60 years behind bars. When he walked out, he was 83 years old. He was Texas's longest serving inmate. When Stewart went to prison for murder, Harry Truman was the president. This was from 1945 to 1953. World War II just ended. The average salary was $956. A new car was about $800. And gas was 18 cents. Life was pretty damn good. So coming out of prison for Harvey Stewart, it was much different. Making his 18 cents in prison wasn't gonna cut it for him in the real world. And you know what? Most convicts on this list, or just in general, most convicts who have spent so much time in prison are not able to adapt to the real outside world. I've read so many inmates who actually ask to stay in prison because they don't know of any other world, or quickly just commit another crime so they can be sent back home. Number 5, we have Richard Honig, who served 63 years behind bars. He was a telegraph operator and a son of a wealthy dealer in farm equipment. Well, this was back in 1899, by the way, hence being a telegraph operator. I mean, what the heck is that these days? Well, Honig was 20 years old when he was arrested in Chicago for a murder. Honig was a very, very bad person. He stabbed the assistant warden with a handcrafted knife. He served 20 days in confinement for that infraction, and he was shackled with a ball and chain for 6 months. Again, shackled with a ball and chain, this is a long time ago. After those incidents, he kept clean, worked in the prison bakery for 35 years. There was huge media attention when he was released from prison at the age of 84 years old. He was released into a nursing home where he was able to live another 13 years before passing away at the age of 97 years old. Moving into number 4, we have a very interesting man who made no sense, well, at least not to me. We're talking about Bill Wallace. He was locked up in J. Ward Prison, which was for the criminally insane. It housed many famous people. Back in 1926, Wallace was suspected of murdering a man in a cafe in Melbourne, Australia. A policeman was nearby the scene and he was able to arrest Wallace, who was the suspect at the time. When he was taken in for questioning, he refused to answer any questions or talk about the crime. There was no witnesses and no admission to the crime, and Wallace was found unfit to plead to the crime as he was declared insane by two different doctors. He was sentenced away at J. Ward Prison at the governor's pleasure, which means the governor can feel like if Wallace has been cured or is able to live in society again, he can just let him go. Like, there was no sentencing on this man. Was he there for a day? Was he there for 10 years? Well, all Wallace had to do was talk and work with the doctors, but he refused to talk with the doctors, so he became institutionalized for the next 64 years. Once he reached 100 years in prison, the word got around and there was a petition to release him, so with all of the pressure, he was released shortly after. But again, to remind you guys, he was never sentenced for a length of time. He lived just 1 month shy of his 108th birthday. Number three, we have Howard Christensen, who served 64 years in prison. Unfortunately, he was sentenced to spend the majority of his life behind bars when he was only 16 years old. So what crime did he commit to deserve this cruel punishment? Well, when he was hitchhiking with one of his friends, they killed the teacher while robbing her. So yeah, I'd say this sentence was pretty much justified. But you guys tell me. You guys be the judge on this one. The judge originally sentenced him to life without parole, but it was later changed to 200 years. The other kid ended up hanging himself in prison several years later. I guess he couldn't deal with the guilt, or he didn't want to spend the rest of his life looking at metal bars. While Christensen was in prison, he was a difficult inmate. He was usually punished with shock therapy for his bad behavior, and he even had a frontal lobotomy done. I mean, ouch, but in 1995, the warden wanted to release him after spending years in prison and mental institutions. They had a hard time finding a place for him, so he was actually released in 2001 and he passed away in 2003. So in reality, he only experienced 18 years as a free man. At number two, we have Charles Ford. He spent 64 years behind bars for an assault. This was a crime he didn't do, and it took 64 years with the help of technology to prove that. He was only 20 years old at the time he was convicted, and he walked out of prison in his 80s. He was released from prison into a nursing home. He probably got so old he had no idea what was going on. Also, what if you had dementia in prison and you're innocent, and you can no longer fight for your own justice because you don't know what anything is anymore? Very flawed, and it's sad hearing about all these, you know, these many stories we've been talking about. Ford was the longest serving inmate in Maryland. He is a black man who was convicted by an all-white jury members in a time where racism was a very big thing. One of the victims actually identified a different man as her attacker, but the judge argued, saying that both men looked, you know, alike enough. It was enough alike. Ford at the time was the only person present at the first conviction, so he was tried and he was just convicted because there was nobody else. And now coming in number one, we have John Phillips, the man who spent 66 years of his life in prison. Back in 1952, Phillips has been behind bars, and this is after he was arrested on sexual assault charges. He was only 18 years old at the time and was only in the 9th grade. He has failed many times, it seems like. Phillips was evaluated by doctors and they determined that he has the mind of a 7-year-old. And during the hearing, his lawyers took a plea deal that got him locked up for the past 66 years. He was able to outlive his prison sentence at the age of 85 years old. Phillips has been clean and out of trouble for the past 29 years. He committed no disciplinary infractions. Although Phillips pleaded guilty to the crime, there is a chance he didn't commit any crimes, which is just so messed up. And now with the loss of medical and court records, it's virtually impossible to do any DNA tests or to even reopen the case. But I suppose at this point, I mean, this man has already served almost 7 decades behind bars. Well, there you guys have it. I just want to say thank you so much for Raid for sponsoring this video, for making this video possible. Make sure you guys check out the free-to-play game in the link down below. That's it for me, guys. I was your host, Landon Do Not Sing, and I will see you guys all in the next Most Amazing Top 10 video.